What's up, boys and girls? Do you want to create a game on Roblox Studio, but every time you try, your FPS is lower than your friend's potato PC? Well, I've got the best solution. The issue lies in the API, or application programming interface, used for rendering graphics in applications, especially games and 3D simulations. Usually, apps use DirectX 11, which is better suited for older machines. That's why your friend's potato PC works, and yours doesn't. This issue is the easiest to solve. You just need to go to File, then press Studio Settings. Now, in this panel, go to Rendering. In the General section, click on Graphics Mode. There, you'll find a variety of API options. Now, we have a lot of APIs. When using Auto, it will choose DirectX 11. Metal is for Apple. There is also no graphics option that won't work, but OpenGL or Vulkan should work and fix the FPS issue. You can also search online for the best API for your graphics card. For my PC with a GTX 1050, the best choices were Vulkan or DirectX 12. Now, after choosing your best API, you need to close Roblox Studio and relaunch it. You should already see your FPS increase to 60. For me, I only get 50 FPS because I use OBS to record, but if I don't, I have a stable 60 FPS. If you're still watching, pretty please subscribe. I also have a bonus setting for you. Now, let's take a look at another issue. Sometimes, you can have multiple GPUs. For example, I like to have two GPUs, one GPU from my CPU and a separate GPU. The issue is that sometimes the app might choose to run on the first GPU, which is the worst one. But this is an easy fix. Open Task Manager, select Roblox Studio, right-click, and go to Open File Location. We'll copy the location from the File Explorer. Now, there are multiple locations where you can make these settings. The easiest way is to go from Windows Settings to Graphics Settings. There's also the NVIDIA Control Panel. For AMD, it should be in the AMD app under Graphics Settings. Here, we will add our app using the file location we copied earlier. Then, navigate to the file and select the GPU you want to use. There might be slight differences in your Windows version, as I am using the latest Windows 11. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.